Okay, so I just wanted to do a quick dissection of some body language with a dog meeting a cat for the first time. So this is Dodger. He's on a place command, and this is our brand new kitten, Torvi. They have never met. This is their first interaction. So let's get into it. So right here, Dodger looks a little bit unsure, but tail's wagging. Okay, so he's not fixated on the cat. He's looking at me. Okay. I'm just observing right now. Kitten is curious. Right here, this is the first thing I noticed. He's got some whale eye. Now, what that is basically he's too tense to turn his body, but he won't let the kitten out of his sight. So even after he turns his head a little bit, still doing that. He looks at me. That's a good sign. So he's not fixated on the cat. But here, the kitten is getting ready to move forward. So let's keep watching him. So as the kitten moves forward, he's still very, very stiff.
Good boy. All right, Raider, you want to come grab Torvi?
So let's watch that little clip again. So his tail's wagging, which is a good sign, but is not a telltale. A lot of times dogs can look, if you're just looking at the tail as the only indicator, they can look very happy and then all of a sudden do something not so happy. So he's still very, very tense as kitten approaches. So I lean in there. That's when you see the camera move forward. All I did was lean in toward him from the chair I was sitting in, and he backed away. So that was me just using some spatial pressure to break up that interaction, because without that, it looked like to me, if anything bad was going to happen, it was going to happen within about the next 2 seconds. And now this doesn't necessarily mean that anything bad was going to happen. This could have been a perfectly fine interaction. He could have sniffed the kitten, licked the kitten, rolled over and not done anything. But if we don't know for sure, I would rather err on the side of caution. So a lot of times what I'll do with the initial interactions, so depending on how the both animals are taking the intros, the first 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe even 5 times, if it's a dog that's got known reactivity to other animals, talking dogs or cats or anything, I would do more. But the first at least 1 or 2 times, if there's any kind of body language like this that puts a question mark in my mind about what's going to happen, I'll just end the interaction just like that. So I had Raider come get the kitten, move her away, the interaction was done. So whatever tension was there was diffused before it could become a negative interaction. So even if Dodger was having negative thoughts and was thinking about hurting the cat, or just saying, get away from me, like whatever it was, if he was having any negative thoughts and was potentially going to do something negative, that was diffused. So even if he had those thoughts and that same experience a couple times with the kitten, I'm actually walking him right now. That's why I keep going back and forth. I don't want to get out of my Wi-Fi range. but even if he did, if we can facilitate those first couple experiences to be really non-eventful, then the next time we introduce, he's gonna have less of a response. He's gonna be less interested. He knows that likely this is going to be uneventful. Kitten's not going to do anything, whatever. So if you're watching those little subtle cues, you'll notice each next time you introduce the animals, there's less tension, more relaxation, and you can have more confidence that nothing bad is going to happen with the two. I just wanted to point that out. Dodger does not have a history of going after other animals. I don't necessarily think he was going to do anything bad, but those are things that I'm always looking for. So if I'm seeing tension, I'm just going to diffuse. A lot of times that's with spatial pressure, maybe a little tug on the leash, maybe just saying, hey buddy, getting him to redirect his attention for a moment, anything like that to diffuse that situation. So hopefully that's a little nugget that can help you in your home or at your friends' homes. And comment if you have any questions. Talk to you guys later.